masterclass series where we discuss topics of musical interpretation. So in last week's video, we discussed the first most important question that we must ask ourselves when coming to interpret a piece of music: what? All the what questions were discussed last time. If you didn't have a chance to see it, check the link below. The second question that we come to is why. And the why question is really where creativity starts to take part. It's a very abstract question with no concrete answers. So really what we need to do is we need to be creative in looking at the information we've gathered in the what question stage and apply creative thinking to why the what is what it is. So I'm going to give you a few examples just to kind of like get the juices, the thinking going, but this is a place where it is very, very personal. This is where really a person's true self comes to shine. So, question number one: why did the composer write this piece of music? Sometimes we know, sometimes we don't, but it's a worthwhile attempt to figure out if we know anything about this. What is the background of it? It was dedicated to someone specifically. What did that person mean to them? And so why was it written? The second question is, why the composer name it the way they named it? You know, okay, sometimes we have pieces like concerto, sonata, which don't really mean anything. However, sometimes we have pieces that the name of it means a lot to us. Even more so, why did they give the tempo markings that they did? So for instance, sometimes, again, we have something like allegro. That doesn't mean very much to us, okay? But if there is allegro ma non troppo, which, for instance, Brahms loves to write, why? Why did he add those words in there? What is he trying to tell us about the music? Why was the music set to a specific genre? Why is it in a sonata form or rondo or whatever it is? Next step, compare the music that you have in front of you to the reduction. This is kind of going a bit deeper in. But we look at the notes, right? And the question that kind of has to guide us is, why did the composer take the time and waste all the expensive ink and paper into writing this music? What was the value of it? Why did he do the things that he did the way that he did it, and not another way? By the way, I apologize for saying he. I appreciate that there's many, many wonderful female composers. It is just an easier way for me to discuss it. But it applies to, obviously, all composers. So compare, take the music and look at the reduction. What does that mean? It means if we were to analyze the music kind of like in a Schenkerian way, if you don't have experience with this, you can look it up. But take the notes that are central, that are absolutely essential to the music. Those are kind of our reduction notes. Now, there are many, 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 many notes on top of that, right? So those are not necessary, so to speak. So why are they there? What are they doing? Are they adding a certain element, a certain depth to the music? What is that depth? What is the composer trying to achieve with adding all those notes that don't actually do anything in the big picture? Those are actually very important questions to ask. Next, why is the rhythm and the meter the way that it is? For instance, okay, sometimes we have 4-4, but even 4-4 can be written with a C sign. That means something else to us, right? Or for instance, if music is written in 6-8 versus 3-8, all of those questions can tell us a lot about the meaning and the music. Next, why are the notes what they are, right? Many times we have repeated notes. We have all these things, like notes that are unexpected, not what you expect normally to be written by this composer or by any composer, right? We have kind of the standard things that we expect. And anything that does not follow the standard expectation has meaning. What is that meaning? What are those notes? Where are those moments where the composer deviates from what we expect, and what is he trying to give to us with this music? Next, look at all the accents, articulations, the performance markings. Why are they there? Sometimes they're expected, sometimes they're not. What do they mean to us? Why did the composer write those in? Now look at the same musical material. For instance, if we have a piece in sonata form or a piece in some other format that has repetitions of the same material, like rondo, ABA, whatever it may be, look at the music and compare the same material, the same phrases, the same melodies, etc., between different sections of the same piece. Are they the exact same? If so, why? Are they different? How are they different? Why are they different? We can continue with asking so many why questions. This is just to kind of give you an opening to the kind of questions which apply to many composers. And again, every composer is different. Every piece is different. For instance, Beethoven, that would scratch and erase and rewrite all of his music so many times, he took so much care and detail that we would put as much importance into every single one of those details because it mattered to him. However, Mozart, that wrote music without thinking about it twice, as easily as I go take a walk outside, then we would approach that a little bit differently. Not to say that the details don't mean anything in Mozart, they do. But it is a different approach than someone like Beethoven, who took a lot of care in every single detail. So the next time, we're going to go on to the next question, which is how. And how is what kind of most of our life revolves around of practice, because, okay, now we know the what, we know all the details, we kind of have at least some ideas of why, of the meaning, of what this music means to the composer, what it means to us. Now the how question is, how do we take that? And then we use these four strings, these four fingers and this right hand to express that, to make that truly come through, both in a way that is respectful to the music and the composer, and in a way that is meaningful to us and to our audience. Thank you so much.